2.2 instructional video for math 20-1. This is where we start to look at the trig ratios for any angle. And the way that we do that is really by drawing right angle triangles. So if we had, you know, some kind of, you know, theta angle in standard position, and I'm just gonna draw the quadrant one first, that if I drew that in quadrant one, then what we could identify is that a point on the terminal arm could be labeled as x comma y, just like we would normally. Remember that a big part of this drawing these angles in standard position is that we are putting them on the Cartesian plane, that xy axis that we've been graphing with for so long. And the reason why that's so important is that if I drop a vertical line down, then what's going to happen is that this side of the triangle is whatever the y value is, this side of the triangle is whatever the x value is, and then right here we would have a nice right angle because x is horizontal, y is vertical. Now there's one other piece that we label this triangle with, and certainly the language that you've used before with that SOHCAHTOA, and I'm going to write SOHCAHTOA out before I forget, because that is typically how students kind of start this chapter. When we talk about rotating around, the language they actually use is R. And what that is the radius of the terminal arm. That's where, how we use it in Math 30 and beyond, and a couple other things as well. But what I'd like to link in that triangle itself, remember that theta would be right here, is that if we looked, and I'm going to write out the three trig ratios. So sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. In this particular triangle, then, sine theta, the opposite side we labeled as y, and the hypotenuse side is labeled as r. For cos theta, according to SOHCAHTOA, it's the adjacent over the hypotenuse. If we apply that to our angle in standard position, we see that cos theta is equal to x over r. And then the last one, which is tan theta, that's equal to opposite over adjacent, according to our SOHCAHTOA trick. But in reference to, you know, x, y, and r, tan theta is actually equal to y over x. Now, when we draw our triangles out, really what this means is that if we give you a point on the terminal arm, we have given you x and y. What you will very rarely be given directly is r. But fortunately, that's a right angle triangle. So in right angle triangles, we can say the hypotenuse squared is equal to the sum of the opposite and adjacent sides squared, which means that r in this triangle is equal to just the positive root of x squared plus y squared. Now, the reason that it's just the positive root is r is defined as the distance from the origin to that point on your terminal arm. And so because it's a distance, we never give it a negative value. X and y, on the other hand, can be negative. And, you know, there's a lot of different ways of kind of walking you through this, but the bottom line is that I am going to look at sine theta being y over r, cos theta being x over r, and tan theta being y over x. And then what I want to do is I want to look at that Cartesian plane, and I'd like you to think about the signs on x and y. In quadrant one, x is positive and y is positive. In quadrant two, x is negative but y is positive. In quadrant three, everybody's negative. And then in quadrant four, x is positive and y is negative. Now, the reason why that's so important is because we could actually use that to talk about which trig ratios are positive. Now, in quadrant one, because everything is positive, they are all positive. And we're going to introduce an acronym when we get to this. In quadrant two, because the x is negative, anything that involves the x, so cos theta and tan theta, is going to be negative. So only sine of an angle is positive in the second quadrant. In quadrant three, because y is negative and x is negative, sine and cos are negative. But tan would always be a negative number divided by a negative number, which means that tan of an angle would be positive in quadrant three. In quadrant four, the sine of an angle is negative and the tan of the angle is negative. And then cos is the only positive angle. Now, you know, I wrote this out because I'd like to talk about where it comes from. But the bottom line is that this is useful for when we talk about the trig of angles in all four quadrants. What we use is something called the CAST acronym. And it's what I wrote over there. We just typically don't write cos, all, sine, and tan every time. And what it does is CAST tells us where each of our trig ratios are positive. And that's something that we're going to exploit, because typically when we use CAST, we can actually, you know, take a look at the triangle, and it should be a little bit of a guide. If I was going to take, you know, the sine of 230 degrees, I immediately know that it's negative, because 230 degrees is in quadrant three, and the sine of any angle in quadrant three is negative. And we'll look at that in more detail as we work through the examples in 2.2.